chronic wasting disease has come to Idaho. Once CWD has infected an area, whether it's in the ground or plants or soil, it doesn't go away. And it's 100% fatal for all deer and elk that pick it up. So what does that mean for hunters? With the discovery of CWD here, the Idaho Fish and Game Commission has designated two units in the state, you know, 14 and 15, as a chronic wasting disease management zone. So what can hunters do that are hunting in this area? They can take the boned out meat and the quarters from any deer or elk they harvest home with them. So what are hunters required to leave behind? Hunters are required to leave all the carcass except for their edible meat, which is required to salvage. If a hunter wants to take the head, in order to take it out of the zone, the head must be cleaned and free of all brain and spinal matter. So all animals harvested within the chronic wasting disease management zone, units 14 and 15, are required to be sampled and tested for chronic wasting disease. If an animal comes back positive, Idaho Fish and Game will contact the hunter and they will be made aware of the results. If it is positive, we also recommend hunters do not eat that animal. If a hunter harvests an animal in unit 14 or 15, Idaho Fish and Game has provided a number of barrels around the units and also along Highway 95 and a number of other areas where you can deposit the head and then the animal will be sampled for chronic wasting disease. In order to comply with chronic wasting disease regulations, one recommended method for cleaning your deer or elk is the gutless method, and I will demonstrate that. Once you've validated and attached your tag, it's time to start processing the deer. For beginning cuts, I run my knife down the back here, and then I'll peel the hide back and take my front quarter and my hind quarter and front quarter, and then I'll go ahead and take my loin. So I'm gonna go ahead and start now. All right, I'm gonna remove the front leg here and set it on a clean surface, preferably a tarp or some other plastic. One other key when you're cutting and skinning an animal out is to cut from underneath the hide. If you cut down from the top, it cuts the hairs and gets the meat a lot dirtier and just makes more of a mess. So remember to cut from underneath. As I continue on the hindquarters here, a couple more things to remember. According to Idaho Fish and Game regulations, you need to leave evidence of sex. And if you're hunting in a whitetail or mule deer only hunt, you need to leave evidence of species also attached. So in order to leave evidence of sex, I'm just gonna cut through the scrotum on the back here and leave that attached to the hide. Cut down through the ball joint in here. All right, so the final step here on this side is to go ahead and cut the back straps out, which I'm gonna go ahead and demonstrate. Again, you wanna take care not to get any part of the spinal cord in with your back strap here. I have a clean back strap there. I'm gonna go ahead and set it over here with the rest of the meat. And the last step is I'm going to reach in and grab a tenderloin, which is located right here at the end of the ribs. This would be for a legally harvested or salvaged deer. There is a lot more good meat on a deer that you can salvage, but you're not required to by law, like neck meat and meat on the ribs is good. So the tenderloins sit along the bottom of the spine inside the body cavity on a deer. There's our deer tenderloin. Just to finish the process, I'm gonna flip this deer over and do the same on the other side. So all deer killed within the CWD zone are required to be sampled. You can either do it yourself, which I'm gonna demonstrate now, or you can drop the head off at one of the head barrels. I'm gonna cut through from the kind of the windpipe here in towards the, just in front of the ears a little bit. The lymph nodes are usually down here close to the brain. So here's one of them. So these lymph nodes are generally a little bit larger than a peanut, but just take care not to mistake them with salivary glands, which are a lot softer. These are usually much harder texture than the salivary glands. So these CWD sampling bags that we use with Idaho Fish and Game, they have type A animal, where it was harvested, all the rest of that, just fill them out completely. On the inside of these, there's a business card, and every business card has a barcode, which is what you can look up to see if your sample is positive or negative after it's been submitted.